Is there a connection between global pandemics and climate change? Can the management of pandemics teach us something about the climate crisis? What do we actually mean by the climate crisis? My name is Professor Colin Price, and I am an atmospheric scientist here at Tel Aviv University, focusing on climate change, natural hazards, and severe weather. Our planet has a fever. When we have a fever, our normal body temperature, which is close to 37 degrees, goes up by 1, 2, maybe 3 degrees. A 4-degree fever will kill us. Well, the Earth also has a fever of about 1 degree at the moment, but if we don't do anything about it, the fever may reach 4 degrees by the end of the century. And the average temperature of the Earth is 15 degrees, not 37 degrees, and therefore a few degrees warming of the entire Earth is much more significant compared with the human. So what's causing this fever? The atmosphere of the Earth acts like the windows of a greenhouse, allowing the sunlight to come in, but not allowing all the heat to leave, warming the surface temperatures like putting a blanket over the Earth. Without the natural greenhouse effect due to the atmosphere, our temperatures would be minus 18 degrees and not 15 degrees. Our oceans would be solid ice, and we would not be sitting here, you would not be sitting here listening to the lecture today. The gases that warm the climate are called greenhouse gases, and today, due to all our activities on Earth, the concentrations of greenhouse gases have increased dramatically in the last 100 years. Put in context, the concentration of greenhouse gases in the atmosphere were fairly constant over the history of civilization, but started dramatically increasing after the Industrial Revolution. The main greenhouse gases that we are contributing to the atmosphere are carbon dioxide, methane, CFCs, and nitrous oxide. In the figure, we can see how these have dramatically increased in the last 200 years. These greenhouse gases are produced by generating energy, transportation, agriculture, and industries all over the world. And with the increasing world population, there is no end in sight. But do we really need to worry? Based on the state-of-the-art predictions for the future, yes, we do need to worry. If we do not make some major changes in the way we run our lives, our cities, and our countries, the forecasts are not good. Increasing global temperatures will bring increased heat waves, drought, and wildfires in some parts of the world, while other locations will be hit by intense storms, hurricanes, and floods. In addition, we can expect rising sea levels that will flood many coastal cities around the globe. Maybe all the forecasts are wrong, and we should just wait and see. But maybe not. So what can we do about it? Everything we do on this planet requires energy, and the vast majority of this energy comes from fossil fuels, coal, oil, and natural gas. Without a revolution in how we produce our energy, we cannot solve this crisis. We need to move away from fossil fuels and invest heavily in renewable clean energies. If we look here at the graph, the y-axis shows the cost of energy to you and me every month, how much we pay for our electricity bill, how much we pay for a gasoline in our car. And for all of us, it's still cheaper for all of us to get our energy from fossil fuels. While too expensive to use renewables, electric cars, solar panels on our homes, that's where we are today. But as coal and oil become more scarce in the next 100 and even 1,000 years, the price will go up. On the other hand, renewable energies depend only on innovation and our minds. Hence, this will continue to get cheaper with time. The question is, when will these two lines cross? When the lines cross, we're on the way to solve the problem of the climate crisis. Why would anyone want to buy a polluting car that costs more than a clean, cheaper car? Why would I pay the electric company more money for its polluting electricity if I can get cheap electricity from my solar panel on my roof, with a battery to store the energy in the nighttime? The goal for all of us is to bring the crossing point of these two lines closer to the present. This is possible, but we need our governments to act fast and the world to come together to solve this crisis.